A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 28 December, on the front page you have Army respects rights of adversaries. So this is General Bipin Rawat, Army Chief, who has said that Indian Armed Forces have the most respect for human rights and pointed out that the human rights cell in the Army headquarters was being upgraded to the level of a directorate. Yesterday we saw in news his statement on the protests as such, as resulted in furor on social media that Army Chief is indulging in politics. Then this is regarding how a plane crashed near Almaty International Airport in Kazakhstan. 12 people died and nearly 100 passengers crashed into a building shortly after takeoff. So this is a disaster which occurred in Kazakhstan. On page 4 you have National Green Tribunal seeks report on clearance to thermal plant. So a plea has been, petition has been filed before NGT challenging the validity of environmental clearance granted to this thermal power plant in Bulandshahr. So the National Green Tribunal has directed Central Pollution Control Board and IIT Delhi to collect relevant data and furnish a report. So you can see a petition moved by an NGO, Social Audit for Forest and Environment, SAFE. So it has sought direction from the NGT to collect ambient air quality for the winter months this season. On page 5 you have villagers in MP oppose removal of Godman's shrine. So villagers damaged an earth mover and a jeep in Ratpani Wildlife Sanctuary in Raisen district in Madhya Pradesh. So authorities removed a shrine of a local godman, and this shrine was encroaching upon the point of origin of Betwa River. So when this shrine was demolished as such, removed, the villagers here damaged the equipments and the earth mover jeep of the police of the authorities. On page 7 you have Mahadai River dispute. If need be, we'll go against Union Minister, says Sawant. So this is Goa Chief Minister Pramod Sawant, who says that the case is pending in Supreme Court and people need not worry regarding Mahadai River dispute with the neighboring Karnataka. So here you can see Union Ministry actually has written to Karnataka stating that environment clearance was not required for its Kalsa Bhanduri River drinking water project on Mahadai River. So Goa and Karnataka are in dispute on this river because Goa has opposed this Kalsa Bhanduri drinking water project. So it is diverting the water of this river. Mahadai, you should know, is known as Mandovi in Goa. On page 8 you have, now Norwegian tourist asked to leave country. So a Norwegian tourist visiting the country ran into trouble as FRRO, Foreigners Regional Registration Office authorities in Kochi asked her to immediately leave the country after emerged that she had participated in a protest march against Citizenship Amendment Act in Kochi. So earlier we had seen a German student being sent back, and now this is a Norwegian tourist who has been sent back, who has been asked to go back. And here you have, this is regarding Kalaripayattu. So this is a martial art form, fighting form, which is said to be one of the oldest art forms that originated in Kerala, dating back to 3rd century BC. And here you have rupees 10 crore for research team to set up center of excellence. So a team of researchers will be granted 10 crores for setting up a center of excellence in health outcomes, research and economics. So these are winners of a competition which was held. So they would be given funding for setting up centers of excellence. So this is a private initiative, not a government initiative. And this is regarding winged visitors flocking Pulikat Lake. So here you can see, this is Pulikat Lake in Andhra Pradesh. So the annual Flamingo Festival here in Nellore district is round the corner, and the flamingos have started arriving here. So they arrived during winter months. On editorial page you have first territorial fuel to the fire. So this is regarding how Citizenship Amendment Act has been put in effect, and also NPR is proposed to be updated across the country. So in this, the burden of proof of citizenship, it is on the person, on an individual. So here the editorial says that burden of proof must not be on the people to prove their citizenship. Rather, government should prove that they are not citizens of the country, if that is the case. So, and this is decisive shift. So this is regarding Chief of Defense Staff, how the post which has been established now could finally bring about unison amongst the armed forces. So we have Chief of Army, Chief of Navy, Chief of Air Force, and then we have a Chief of Armed Forces as such. But then there is a need for integrated chief of all three forces, and that post has been created now, the Chief of Defense Staff. So this is the lead article is in CAA narrative, finding the judiciary's lost voice. So in the Citizenship Amendment Act protests and views, counter views given, what will be the judge's role? So it says it is a watershed moment for the judiciary not to falter and for judges to undo the wrongs of the past. This is an article on that, and this is how not to counter economic stagnation. So this article actually goes the other way and says what government should not do, because we are seeing stagnation, that is inflation plus lowering growth as such. So that is called stagflation also. So the government, it says, has to garner resources and give boost to the economy by increasing its investments. The government should put in the money so that there is more money in the economy and economy gets a boost. Then on Saturdays, you have on the OPEC page Ground Zero coverage, so on one particular issue. So today the issue is on Andhra Pradesh. The Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister Jagmohan Reddy, he announced that the Andhra Pradesh government would set up three capitals. The previous government had announced in Andhra Pradesh a new capital being formed at Amravati, and steps have been taken for it. Land has been acquired from farmers. Farmers have given up their fertile land, and infrastructure development has begun. Government seat is proposed to be established here, and now the present government says that three capitals would be established, one in Amravati, one in Kurnool. So this proposal as such has been questioned, you can see. So it is also geographically spread apart, Kurnool, Amravati and Vishakhapatnam, as three capitals, legislative, executive, judiciary. So it says after 5 years of planning on using 33,000 acres of pooled land for an unfinished mega capital, Andhra Pradesh is now exploring newer options. So this article speaks on the promises and realities of Amravati and the impact the new government's three capital proposal has had on the region's farmers. So farmers have been protesting here. On page 12, you have compulsory renewal of OCI card goes. So Union Home Ministry has relaxed provisions for overseas citizens of India card holders that made it compulsory for those aged above 50 or below 20 to renew their cards on renewal of their passports. So this has been dropped now. So there's no need for these age groups to renew OCI cards on renewal of passport now. Then on international page, you have this coverage of news of the front page image which we saw about Kazakhstan plane crash. It is said nearly 100 people were on board on the aircraft that came down soon after takeoff and slammed into a house. Then below you have climate change caused 15 disasters this year. So at least 15 natural disasters are linked to climate change this year and have caused damage of over $1 billion each, and 7 of them cost at least $10 billion. So this is a study which has found regarding how climate change is affecting and various continents, across the globe, causing floods, storms, fire. On business page, you have gross NPAs may rise to 9.9% by next September, says RBI report. So RBI report says that gross non-performing assets ratio of banks may increase to 9.9% by September 2020 from 9.3% in September 2019, because there are risks to growth. Twin engines of consumption and investment are the key challenges according to RBI Governor Shaktikant Das. And below you have commercial trial run begins on freight corridor. So this is regarding the dedicated freight corridor which has been established between Delhi to Mumbai. So opening of a stretch of this corridor is in news, you can see. So this is the first section which has been opened on the under construction 1500 kilometer western freight corridor. So this is a total of 664 track kilometer which has been opened. So this is this will benefit the regions in this as such, which are in Rajasthan and Haryana. So trial runs would begin, commercial trial runs. Freight corridor is for movement of goods on the railways. So goods movement will be faster once work is completed. So that is it. These are the important headlines. The last page is sports related news. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. We cover current affairs news as such on that. The gist of news of every item is provided there, and also PDFs are available for download. Thank you.